Let's talk a little basketball first. All right, let's do it. Tigers, even though they didn't make the big dance, right, so to speak, they did get an invitation to the NIT. How would you kind of summarize this entire season, especially with Penny Hardaway at the helm?
I think it's been a fabulous season for them. I think that they recaptured the heart, mind, and spirit of the community in terms of that. And Penny absolutely did that, Penny, the coaching staff, and the players. I think he did about as much as he could with the team that he inherited. And who I'm most excited about is Martin.
Jeremiah,
you talk about stepping up, and now he's got an opportunity. I believe he's going to be drafted in the NBA. Wow.
So not to look past the NIT, but let's look past the NIT, because as you know, yes, he captured the hearts and minds, but Memphis fans have a short attention span, and you got it. So what does he have to do next year?
I just think he's going to get more engagement. He has some great players coming in. He has some top five players coming in, and I think Penny has the heart of the kids. And I think we're going to see, we have yet to see what's best coming from that program. I predict, and I've said it earlier, I see in 2 to 3 years, Final Four easy.
It's the number
back
one
to greatness
scene,
again.
Back to greatness.
Okay.
I believe Penny is the right man, as I've said before. He's a phenomenal coach, and I think what you see this year is just the tip of the iceberg.
So as long as we make some progress on the wins next year, the community will be patient.
Oh, yes. Okay.
So, Howard, let's talk about the NCAA tournament itself, though.
Sure.
We've got Tennessee.
Yes.
I noticed that orange pocket.
Yes, my youngest son is a graduate of University of Tennessee.
Congratulations.
Did you see the Auburn game? The Auburn game yesterday?
I did not see the Auburn game.
That was a good decision.
So how do you think we stand in the tournament, though, with Tennessee, a big part of this, I believe, Ole Miss, Mississippi State.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Belmont's got to play in.
Yes.
I urge everyone to really pull for our regional teams. I mean, you know, I know that we can be dead set against them when they're playing against our favorite team, but I love to see teams from this part of the world, being Tennessee and the Mid-South, go in and do well. So I think number of teams to watch, Houston. Keep your eye on Houston. Houston's a great team. Keep
they
your
played eye a on phenomenal
Cincinnati.
Game against
Cincinnati.
Us until the last 4 minutes of that
absolutely,
game.
Right. Absolutely.
Who is the underdog? You know, March Madness loves nothing better than an underdog. Yes. And Gonzaga used to always be, but shoot.
Look at Larry over there. He says he's got two.
I got two. Buffalo. Buffalo has got a great basketball program. Pay attention to them. But there's a guy that's a little bit north of here that's going to be a lottery pick. His name is Ja Morant.
Yeah.
This kid is awesome.
Murray State.
I mean, he's Murray State, right to the north of us in Kentucky. But I tell you, this kid is setting the world on fire.
Really?
He's fun to watch. I think he averaged something like 24 points, 10 assists, about 5 rebounds.
Has a crazy vertical jump.
This dude is amazing. And so if nothing else, watch Murray State game, because I think he's going to really shock some people.
We were talking a little bit earlier in the show about Johnny Manziel playing for the Express. Is that a good fit? I mean, coming to the city of Memphis, gentlemen.
Be nice.
What could this potentially do for us?
It could be.
Don't they car it on Beale Street?
Could be.
Do they car it on Beale Street?
Maybe they should if they don't.
It could be a fit. I mean, I don't know. They seem to be looking for a formula, but this
he's an exciting player. Off the field now.
But you know, when he started going south, when they started calling him Johnny Football. Now, that's when it got kind of crazy.
Yeah.
But before we get off of basketball, I've got to get on this one.
What you got to say to me?
So I got something to say to you, man. I ain't scared of you either.
Start moving
Okay. So he said that this has to do with Duke and Zion Williamson.
Yes.
Okay? And you know he blew through the shoe and he hurt his knee and whatnot. My young friend over here was saying that
he should
not be playing. Even given clearance from medical people, he should not be playing. But he got confused. He confused a contract worker with a warrior. this kid is a warrior. He said all he wanted to do was come back and battle with his brother.
So are you thinking about his future?
I'm thinking about his future. This kid got several hundred million dollars on the line when he's right now.
He wants to play, but he's got a passion for ball.
True, but
he wants to play ball.
Are we going to continue this conversation on Sirius XM? Can we do it right there?
Absolutely. Saturday mornings, 2:11. Saturday mornings, 10 a.m. Central.
Sirius XM. These guys right here doing it big time for sure.
Really help him with his basketball knowledge.
All right. Guys, we're out of time, but thank you very much. We appreciate you both being here.